Hello, friends. Good to see you again. Today, we'll talk about colonizing the moon and Mars. 今天的话题是征服月球和火星。First, let's look at a picture. 这是火星探测船。The Mars Probe Pathfinder, 携带漫游小机器人旅行者。The Roving Little Robot, Sojourner, 到达火星的情景。时间是在 Sunday, July 6, 1997, 1997年7月6日。火星是太阳系里离地球最接近的一颗行星。它是一颗细小干旱的红色行星，它的表面布满了岩石。地球人对火星一直充满了好奇，梦想着把人送入火星，甚至在那里居住。这个梦想能实现吗？ Now let's listen to the text and then answer this question. When will it be possible for us to think seriously about colonizing Mars? 我们什么时候才能认真考虑征服火星呢？
The moon is likely to become the industrial hub of the solar system, supplying the rocket fuels for its ships, easily obtainable from the lunar rocks in the form of liquid oxygen. The reason lies in its gravity. Because the moon has only an 1/80th of the Earth's mass, it requires 97% less energy to travel the 250,000 miles from the moon to Earth orbit than the 200-mile journey from Earth's surface into orbit. This may sound fantastic, but it is easily calculated. To escape from the Earth in a rocket, one must travel at 7 miles per second. The comparable speed from the moon is only 1.5 miles per second. Because the gravity on the moon's surface is only 1/6 of Earth's, remember how easily the Apollo astronauts bounded along. It takes much less energy to accelerate to that 1.5 miles per second than it does on Earth. Moon dwellers will be able to fly in space at only 3% of the cost of similar journeys by their terrestrial cousins. Arthur C. Clarke once suggested a revolutionary idea passes through three phases. 1. It's impossible. Don't waste my time. 2. It's possible, but not worth doing. And 3. I said it was a good idea all along. The idea of colonizing Mars, a world 160 times more distant than the moon, will move decisively from the second phase to the third, when a significant number of people are living permanently in space. Mars has an extraordinary fascination for would-be voyagers. America, Russia, and Europe are filled with enthusiasts, many of them serious and senior scientists, who dream of sending people to it. Their aim is understandable. It is the one world in the solar system that is most like the Earth. It is a world of red, sandy deserts, hence its name, the Red Planet. Cloudless skies, savage sandstorms, chasms wider than the Grand Canyon, and at least one mountain more than twice as tall as Everest. It seems ideal for settlement.
好，刚才的问题是 When will it be possible for us to think seriously about colonizing Mars? 回答应该是When a significant number of people are living permanently in space. 当相当多的人固定居住在太空的时候。Right, you've got it. 回答正确。好，下面来看一下整篇课文的内容。这是一篇说明文，说明为什么月球可能成为太阳系的工业中心。可能成为人类居住的地方，并说明为什么征服火星的计划是个好的想法。 值得一试。课文一共有四段，第一段讲月球很可能成为太阳系的工业中心 Industrial Hub of the Solar System， 这是因为月球上有丰富的液态氧 Liquid Oxygen， 可以作为航天飞船的燃料。另外，月球上消耗的能量比地球要少得多。第二段讲为什么月球上消耗能量少，这是因为月球表面的引力 Gravity 仅仅是地球引力的六分之一。第三段讲 Arthur Clarke 关于创新想法需要经过三个阶段的提议，这三个阶段是：第一，根本不可能 ，impossible； 第二阶段，可能但不值得做 ，possible but not worth doing； 第三阶段是值得做 ，worth doing。最后一段讲的是征服火星的计划值得一做，这是因为第一，火星对未来的星际旅客有特殊的魅力；第二，把人送上火星一直是科学家的梦想；第三，火星是太阳系离我们最近的行星；第四，火星看起来适合居住。因此呢，假设有相当数量的人固定居住在太空，根据Arthur Clarke 的提议，征服火星的计划可以从第二阶段进入第三阶段，也就是说值得一做 worth doing。 这篇课文从语言上来说，我们要体会到文章简洁的文体，特别是那些简短的句子，比如说 The reason lies in its gravity，再比如 It's impossible, don't waste my time. It's possible, but not worth doing. I said it was a good idea all along. Their aim is understandable. 还有 It seems ideal for settlement, 等等。好，了解了文章的大意，再来学习重要语言点。So let's move on to language points. 先来看题目。Space Odyssey. Odyssey 意思是 a long journey during which many things happen. 漫长的行程。Space Odyssey 直译的话是在太空的漫长行程，也就是太空探索。 Odyssey 是一个文学用语，它来源于古希腊史诗的名字，相传呢是荷马所作。这部史诗描写了奥德修斯国王利用木马计贡献特洛伊城后回家途中十年历经的种种沧桑经历。课文借用这个词语，既表达了人类探索太空所经历的漫长过程，又增加了课文的生动性。好 ，Odyssey， 我们来看两个例句。The story is about the Odyssey of self-discovery. 这个故事讲的是一个自我发现的历程。Odyssey of self-discovery， 自我发现的历程。His whole life was a spiritual odyssey， 他的整个生活是一次精神之旅。精神之旅 ，spiritual odyssey。好，来看下一个语言点。The moon is likely to become the industrial hub of the solar system。Hub the most important place where a particular activity takes place. 枢纽或者中心的意思。The industrial hub of the solar system. 太阳系的工业中心。这句话讲的是因为月球的岩石中可以很容易提炼出液太阳 liquid oxygen, 可以给航天飞机呢提供燃料。另外月球上耗能少。所以呢能成为 industrial hub, 工业中心。Hub, 我们来看一例句。Beijing is the cultural hub of China.北京是中国的文化中心。好，再来看下一个语言点。Moon dwellers will be able to fly in space at only 3% of the cost of similar journeys by their terrestrial cousins. Terrestrial. Existing on the Earth or happening on the Earth.Instead of in the sky or sea, 地球的或者是人间的意思。Terrestrial cousins, 地球的或者是人间的表兄弟姐妹。这个与前面的 moon dwellers, 月球居民相对称。这个用法使得课文增加些趣味性和生动性。这句话主要讲的是在月球上遨游的费用要比我们低得多。Terrestrial, 我们来看例句。Most terrestrial plants require sunshine, oxygen, and water in order to survive.大多数地球植物靠太阳、氧气和水生存。The idea of colonizing Mars will move decisively from the second phase to the third. Colonize 意思是 to take control of another country by going to live there or sending people to live there.在什么什么地方开拓殖民地或者移民与殖民地的意思也可以拼作 C-O-L-O-N-I-Z-E Colonizing Mars 意思是在火星上开拓殖民地送人呢移居到火星上相当于我们通常说的征服火星。作者认为征服火星的计划是个好主意值得一做。文章最后一段提出几个理由。那就是说 Mars has an extraordinary fascination for would-be voyagers. It is our dream to send people to Mars. It is the one world in the solar system.That is most like the Earth. And lastly, Mars seems ideal for settlement. Colonize. 来看一例句。Britain colonized North America, Australia, and South Africa. 英国曾在北美、澳大利亚和南美开拓殖民地。下一个语言点。Mars have an extraordinary fascination for would-be voyagers. Fascination. The power to interest or attract people very strongly. 魅力。Extraordinary fascination. 特殊的魅力。这句话讲我们地球人希望将来去火星上旅游，因为火星对我们有特殊的魅力。 fascination. 我们再来看例句。The place has held a strange fascination for me ever since. 自从那时起，这个地方对我来说有一种奇怪的魅力。Hold a strange fascination for somebody. 对什么人来说有一种奇怪的魅力的意思。下一个原点。It seems ideal for settlement. Ideal. Of the best or most suitable type. 理想的，完美的。这句话的意思是火星适合居住。Ideal. 来看两个例句。The fair provides an ideal opportunity for job seekers and employers to meet. 招聘会为寻找工作者和用人单位提供了理想的见面机会。Ideal opportunity, 理想的机会。Weather conditions were far from ideal for driving. 天气状况很不适合行车。Far from ideal, 很不适合做某事的意思。All right, that's all for the language points. Now, let's move on to key structures. 先看这一句。Arthur C. Clarke once suggested, a revolutionary idea passes through three phases. Suggest, 在这儿跟一个宾语从句，省略了 that. 应该是 Arthur C. Clarke once suggested that a revolutionary idea passes through three phases. Suggest.在这里是含蓄的指出，或者是暗示的意思，相当于 imply。Suggest 最常用的意思是建议。当建议用的时候，我们常常会出错。现在我们来总结一下 suggest 当建议用的时候的几种常用法。I suggest you should not work under too much pressure.我建议你不要在太大的压力下工作。Suggest 后面跟 should。I suggest you relax more。我建议你更放松一些。Suggest 这儿跟动词原形省略 should。The chairman suggested bring the meeting to an end。主席建议结束会议。Suggest doing something. The article suggested various ways in which English could be improved. 这篇文章提出了许多提高英语的方法的建议。Suggest something. 好，再来看下一个句子。The idea of colonizing Mars, a world 160 times more distant than the moon will move decisively from the second phase to the third when a significant number of people are living permanently in space. 这句话有两点需要引起我们的注意。第一是主句在前。The idea of colonizing ideas will move decisively from the second phase to the third. 从句在后面，作者先把重要的信息告诉你，然后做些补充。我们读完前半句就知道了中心意义。第二，我们要注意，在从句里面，现在进行时态表示将来，而且有不是遥远的将来的含义，给人一种马上要做的感觉。在时间状语里，现在进行时可以用来表示将来时间，比如 You'll get disappointed when you are talking with him. 当你跟他交谈的时候，你会觉得很失望的。 are talking with him， 在这儿其实表示将来时间。好，今天的话题是 Space Odyssey。记得在31课中我们学了海洋勘探，叫 Exploring the Sea Floor。如果把这两篇课文放在一起，会使我们联想到一句话，那就是上九天揽月，下五海捉鳖。人类始终在上下探索。Okay, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time.